नमो शिवाय स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी हैव ऑलरेडी कम्प्लीटेड द चैप्टर मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट्स ऑफ करंट. द लास्ट टॉपिक वाज ईएमआई, दैट इज इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन. नाउ टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई विल डिस्कस सम ऑफ द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स. ओके, यू प्लीज लिसन केयरफुली ऑल द आंसर्स एंड राइट डाउन द क्वेश्चन एज वेल एज द आंसर्स इन योर फिजिक्स कॉपी. दीज क्वेश्चंस आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, so practice these questions and you practice more conceptual based questions, and in the next video I shall discuss about the exercise question answers. Okay, now see the first question. Name the phenomena used for producing current in a coil due to relative motion between a magnet and the coil. Okay, it has been asked that you have to name the phenomena used for producing current. That means current will produce in the coil. How? If there is motion between the magnet and the coil. This one very easy. You all know this one. Answer will be electromagnetic induction, because it is the phenomena by which we can produce or induce current in the coil by the motion between the magnet and the coil. So if there is a coil and if we move the magnet towards the coil, what will happen? The current will produce or induce in the coil. So the answer of question number one is electromagnetic induction. Next, explain two ways to induce current in the coil. This one I have already said while I taught. So what are the two ways by which we can induce current in the coil? The point is, when a magnet is moved towards or away from the coil, right? If the magnet is moved towards or away from the coil, or there is any relative motion between the coil and the magnet, then what happens? A current is induced in the coil. This is one way. And the other way is when the current is passing through the coil changes. Okay, when the current passing through a coil changes, then a current is induced in the coil placed near it. Next question, question number three, a coil of insulated copper wire is connected to a galvanometer. What will happen if a bar magnet is, number one, pushed into the coil, number two, withdrawn from inside the coil, number three, held stationary inside the coil? Okay. So it has been asked that there is one copper wire which is insulated, okay, copper wire in the form of the coil, and it is connected to the galvanometer. Now, if the first question is, what will happen if the bar magnet, now if we bring one bar magnet and pushed inside the coil, so what will happen? What will happen? The galvanometer will show the deflection, we all know. Why? Because, which means that current is induced in the coil. So current is induced in the coil due to the relative motion between the coil and the magnet. Understood? So when the bar magnet is pushed inside the coil, this one I've already taught you with the diagram. Please do watch the videos and try to understand. So the galvanometer shows a deflection when, which means that the current is induced in the coil. Okay, so whenever the bar magnet is pushed inside the coil, you will see, we shall see one deflection. The needle is deflected in the galvanometer. This means that current is induced in the coil due to the relative motion between the coil and the magnet. Next, withdrawn from inside the coil. Now, if the bar magnet is withdrawn from inside the coil, then what will happen? The galvanometer will show the deflection, but in the opposite direction, which means current is induced in opposite direction in this case. So the direction of the motion is in the opposite direction with respect to the coil. Number three, held stationary inside the coil. That means if we place the bar magnet inside the coil, but it is not moving, it is held stationary. What will happen? That means what? Magnet is not moving. What will happen? There will be no deflection in the galvanometer. Why? Because no current is passing. Understood? As when the bar magnet is held stationary, that means there is no movement in the bar magnet. That means there will be no deflection in the galvanometer, as no current is induced in the coil. There is no relative motion between the coil and the current. So no current will be induced in the coil when the bar magnet is held stationary inside the coil. Okay, so when the bar magnet is held stationary, we shall see that the galvanometer coil will not move, will not deflect. So the galvanometer is not showing in any deflection. This means that no current is induced. Okay. Next question, how does a solenoid behave like a magnet? Can you determine the north and the south pole of a current carrying solenoid using a bar magnet? This is a question of your NCERT only. So how does a solenoid behave like a magnet? This one you know, a solenoid will behave like a magnet when the electric current passes through it. Such a solenoid is called electromagnet. Okay, so can you determine the north pole and the south pole of the current carrying solenoid using a bar magnet? See, one end of the solenoid behaves as a north pole and the other end behaves as a south pole. So we can use a bar magnet to determine the north and the south pole of a current carrying solenoid by using the property of like poles repel and unlike poles attract each other by this property. Okay, so the end of the solenoid which will attract north pole of the bar magnet, I repeat, the end of the solenoid that attracts north pole of the bar magnet is magnetic south pole in a solenoid, and the end of the solenoid which repels the north pole of a bar magnet is the magnetic north pole in a solenoid. Okay, so by this way we could identify the north and the south pole. Next question, which property of a proton can change while it moves freely in a magnetic field? So when a proton, that is proton means what, charge particle, so when a proton moves in a magnetic field, then a magnetic force is applied, due to which what happens, the velocity changes, and as the velocity is changing, what happens, the momentum also changes. The last question, a magnetic compass shows a deflection when placed near a current carrying wire, right? So if there is any current carrying wire and magnetic compass is brought, it will show the deflection. There will be deflection in the compass. So how will the deflection of the compass get affected if the current in the wire is increased? So it has been asked that if the current in the wire is increased, that means more current is passing through the wire, how will the deflection will get affected, what will happen to the deflection of the compass? Support your answer with a reason. See, if the current in the wire is increased, what will happen? Obviously the deflection will also increase. If the current is increasing, deflection will also increase, and the strength of the magnetic field is directly proportional to the magnitude of the current passing through the straight conductor. Understood? So the strength, it has been asked, you have to give your answer with the support for a reason. You have to reason, give a reason for the support of your answer. So that is, the strength of the magnetic field is directly proportional to what? Magnitude of the current. If more current is passed, the field, the magnetic field will be also more. Okay, if the current is more, the field strength will be also more. Okay, so this is the reason. So you will write all these question answers in your copy, and next class I shall discuss exercise question answers. Namah Shivaya.